Dear colleague, I would like to present some of the projects which started in the end of last year at our university. This is three strange acronyms. Yeah. First one is a campus project. This is specially for the training in Russia and Kazakhstan. About how they can change their curriculum, especially in computer science. This level, according to the European framework European qualification framework. The speech of from yesterday of Milena Kromova fit very well to this project. And we use some of her results to show the way how to extract the skills and knowledge for the researchers, for the new curriculum, and how to collaborate with industry and to implement in the courses. This is the main goals of the project. First, we had the training in the beginning of this year in February, for a week. 20 of colleagues from Russia and Kazakhstan was here in this building too, and really we had hard work with them. We have 22 partners. Which 15 are from Russia and Kazakhstan. The coordinator is from Ghent University in Belgium. I cannot pronounce your key if you help me.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Then the project is for 3 years, it's continual, and maybe next January, February, we have another training to see how it's work and to go further for the curriculum in computer science. This is the address of the project site. The second, maybe Elena help me more for this. This is especially how to, from one side, to bring our own devices with us and to put everything on the cloud, to use it. This is to discover more dynamic didactics, how to collaborate with different things and different devices and different topics. The coordinator at Duke School from Athena, 57 partners from 18 European countries, and inside 10 schools, which will be a pilot schools for the didactic of the project and the project results. Something additional from your side?
Probably one of the most important things to be developed within the framework of the project will be the competence framework of iTeacher. Yes, the main knowledge and skills, the main competencies to be developed in order to use this cloud computing technology for the purposes of education.
Elena, you're welcome, coordinating.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you, Elena. And the website, if you're interested more in this project, it is for 3 years too. And we'll continue. Next meeting will be in December, in the middle of December, before Christmas. In on North will be. And now we are landed here in Bulgaria. because the coordinator of this project is from Russian University. Here is really, it is the, usually they develop the project to coordinate the network and long life learning projects for education. Again, here the purpose is to fit better the curriculum to the in ICT related areas to the industry, to make really and to share this for the countries all over the Europe, because this is to develop the European strategic framework according for 2020 to develop a European framework for evaluation, for quality of evaluation, and go further with requirements for the future work at the level, school level, especially for ICT, and again new didactic models. Here I set the network. Really, this is the fifth network which developed at the Russian University, 67 partners from 37 countries. 27 of them are from European Community. The others are for Iceland, Norway, Liechtenstein, Turkish, Macedonia, Croatia, Serbia, and Albania. Most of the days interesting for the project, there is six part of the partners, six type of the partners, sorry. This is from one part is from the university and industry, the second is the research organizations, firms, specialized firms of course, NGOs, and associations with not commercial purposes. And this is the site. Usually for this project we have two work meetings per year in different places together with the conference in the autumn is for real learning conference, in summer is end of spring it is for consistent, more oriented to the computer scientist. This project is for 3 years too, and we're working on three of them, and we'll see the results, we'll share the results, and our colleague here, students, will be the first, the pilot version of the, follow the pilot version of the results. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Jane. Are there any questions? Okay.
Jenny, the final project you were talking about, it was about, if I understood you well, preparing a computer kind of course to be taken anywhere, anytime, etc. For what age level is that?
This is the idea, especially for the computer science.
Okay, so it's also at university level.
Yeah. Only for the university level. Yeah.
I would like to add something. Actually, within the project, one of the main objectives is to implement the e-learning in the different curricula. And probably it will have a big impact, I think, on the university involved.
Just one. small comment.
You were talking earlier about, now that you are about to work on the development of some ICT competency framework for teachers. Let me just go back to my presentation yesterday. In 2011, UNESCO and partners, IT partners, but also universities, has developed such a framework. In the annexes, teachers are given concrete, you know, objectives according to the three levels that a teacher may master technology, that is technology literacy, the basic, knowledge deepening and knowledge creation. So please use it, because several countries have already worked with that, and they've been, we have had positive feedback. Not because it's UNESCO, but it's a positive feedback, yes.
Thank you very much. I know this book and share with my colleague, and probably on the next working meeting, partner meeting, we'll use it.
Maybe I could add, we haven't mentioned, I put in my slides, but Eugenia and Elena were involved in developing an online course for UNESCO school network, right. And this framework was used there.
Yeah, we follow it, and we use it in our work, but for some of the projects we propose it, but not in all, I think. Maybe in PICTET, I'm sure, the first one we use UNESCO as additional information for
now for the next meeting. Support the work of the
framework European.
If you could write to me whenever you think you are at that stage, so that I know about it, that would be wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I hope there is internet connection. Yeah, I can show you our.
It was coordinated by Institute of Information Technology,
IIT
in Moscow, so...
Yeah, but they are not the only ones interested in
Yeah, they translate it in Russian.
Yeah, you can translate it into Bulgarian if you want.
Okay.
No, I wanted to
show the court, but we have
no
time.
We are doing this.
Just
for you.
No, you have this in mind. I share the address and access to it.
Thank you.
Because really it is in the course.
Thank you. Thank you very much.